physical brand of hockey without running around.
And that first hit on Malkin was a great example. Drop on the doorstep. What a save! Pascal Leclaire!
Fumble in the backfield.
There's a big man. Fourth line on fourth line. And it usually looks like this. Where is it? That is just a complete reaction save by Pascal Leclaire. And this is what he's capable of doing, though. He's so athletic. He's short in the open. The goal line stands, I call it, because when it's close,
look at that.
He spreads out post to post with the pads and then still has quickness and battle in him. And he's talking to him this morning. He says, hey, I was a goat most of the year. I was hurt. I was traded for. I didn't play well. He goes, right now, I really like it. I mean, because I had one big game. That's being reviewed because of where his pad was.
Okay.
I think it was really close. Where did it hit the pad? Was the pad in the net? That, and don't forget, it was called no goal. Here's the puck. Ooh, they've got to pick up the puck on the pad, and it has to be completely across the line.
There has to be no doubt about it.
Right, because it was no goal signaled at ice level, so it has to be overturned.
Right.
Great job. Great look. It's going to be very difficult to find the puck. It was difficult for everybody, but Leclaire, I can't believe he found it.
Well, we had three reviews in game five.
Yeah, why not?
Continue down the same road.
Here we go again. This will be a look right here. Rupp gets there. Nah, it looks like it's... We're going to freeze that down, slow it down, and see there's the space between the puck. You see the puck in the pad. I mean, Campoli, yeah, it's a great job by our guys to give you what they're looking at in the Situation Room in Toronto.
Wes McCauley is on the horn. As we have pointed out throughout this series, Bob Paul's the series manager representing the NHL. As Dan Bylsma looks on, they go to the Situation Room in Toronto, discuss this.
They'll be able to blow it up. Right. And you have to have white ice between the black puck and the red line. That's what they're looking for. Rupp hopes so. This building hopes not.
We're going to take a look, Darren, from the overhead and see if we can see more.
Up over the shoulder, wacky play. Leclaire looking left, finding it. As it comes up and over his head. Bonus. Jack Daniels net cam view. Yeah, can't tell from there because he's blocking it out.
And we're looking for conclusive evidence to reverse the call. And that's the key from all of this that we see. And there be no doubt whatsoever about what you see is that puck completely over the goal line. We'll see it from the reverse angle again.
And this is going to be more than likely the one look that plays into it more than any other. It's tough with Campoli right there. And they'll go frame by frame. They have that technology.
Oh, boy, oh, boy. Well, we're not going to draw too many conclusions, although this is very close.
That is, and that's why they go and do this.
And the exactness of how they do it is very impressive because they always get it right.
It was a fabulous play all the way around. Fun for the fourth liners crashing and banging. Rupp got there. Leclaire, a fabulous reaction save even to get it to this point. But so, a very big decision pending.
So Wes McCauley, when his dad was a referee, John McCauley, they did not have the technology in place.
No, it was the wave off would have been the way we all lived with it.
Late John McCauley, a Hall of Fame referee.
Yes.
Wes McCauley played college hockey at Michigan State, and we said we had three of these in game five, and now here's our evidence.
Yeah, it was a long game made longer. This one, Chris Kunitz thinks it's because of the whistle, which would be no review, but because that post did not lose contact with the moorings, it's a good goal. This one for Chris Kunitz, not as much fortune.
No goal.